How does OpenRoads Designer manage changes within the design model? OpenRoads Designer and the modeling technology that underlies it really takes advantage of some innovative and unique tools and methodologies. We like to call it design intent. And you might ask, what's design intent? Design intent really is a system of rules and relationships that are captured and stored as you design and as you create elements within your design model. Now, the importance of these rules and relationships are that they remember how you created them so that as you make design changes, as things need to change throughout your design process, those relationships are maintained. That makes making changes and taking into account things that change throughout the process much more effective and efficient. Take a few minutes with me and let's take a look as we explore how design intent or the rules and relationships in OpenRoads Designer make modeling easier and more effective. Let's start off by highlighting the true power of design intent by using what we call a civil cell, which is the epitome of efficient and effective relational modeling. In this example, I've selected a T-intersection civil cell from my library of civil cells, and now I'm defining the elements to which it's going to relate to in my project, in my roadway corridor. So as I place that civil cell element, I select the particular elements that I want it to relate to define its placement within the model, and then the model updates. You can see that T-intersection has been placed within our design model, and it's been placed in relationship to the mainline corridor as we defined it when we placed it. Now we can modify the view. We can change from a transparent to a smooth view if we want to get a different perspective and change the view of that intersection. Now what happens after placement of an element? So let's look at modifications. In this case, we're going to look at the secondary alignment, and I've opened up the profile window of that secondary alignment. You'll note as I select the alignment that there is relationships and definition to that profile alignment. Relationships have been defined along that profile to the pavement cross slopes of the main line. So as we move the horizontal location of that intersection, notice the profile view. The relationship between the profile of the secondary road and the pavement slope of the main line is maintained because of our design intent. So as we relocate that intersection, the integrity of the intersection is maintained. And we can go back, we see that relationship has been sustained within our model. Now what happens again in another instance where we modify the profile of the mainline roadway? So I've opened up the profile of the mainline roadway, and here you can see I have selected it and I'm simply moving that profile around. You can see it in the three-dimensional model as I move it around. Now what will happen to our intersection when we make that modification? So as I place that or make that change, notice the model and the side slopes changing. Now as we continue, let's lower the profile and see the change. Ultimately, because of our design intent, the integrity of the intersections are maintained even with major modifications as we saw in this example. I hope you were able to see the power and efficiency that taking advantage of a rules-based modeling system and the relationships that you're able to impart to your designs with OpenRoads Designer makes modeling and making changes to the model much more effective and easily. Thank you for taking the time to join me. If you'd like more information on OpenRoads Designer, please look us up on Bentley.com or click the link included with this video.